You're listening to Radio Cayman. I'm Shanda Gallego, and this is Cayman Up Close.
Give me your full name and your official title, just for the record.
Right, so I'm Martyn Roper, and I'm the Governor of the Cayman Islands.
Heard that? Governor of the Cayman Islands. 1 year ago, you arrived here in the Cayman Islands. Take us back to the months, the weeks, the days just before you landed. What was it like? Give us that experience, and do you have any expectations or reservations at all?
I remember it being a very busy period because I'd just returned from China, and I left China in early September and came here at the end of October. So I had a very busy sort of 5 or 6 weeks, and because of the situation with my predecessor, it happened quite quickly. So I remember that bit of it. But what sticks in my mind is just an incredibly warm welcome from everybody when I arrived. So you get off the plane with Lizzie, my wife, and you met at the airport, and then almost straight to the Legislative Assembly and delivering a speech, which I'd spent a lot of time working on in the UK to make sure I pitched that right. So you're straight in, and then there was a big reception at Government House, and it was a very long day, and with the jet lag, I remember all of that. But yeah, the Cayman kind welcome really sticks in my mind.
And you mentioned the warm people, but I don't think you mentioned the warm weather either.
It was a hot day. Yeah, and certainly coming from the UK, but the climate here, I really love the climate.
From Halifax, West Yorkshire.
Yes.
I mean, all the way to the Cayman Islands. What has it been like making a home here in the Cayman Islands?
The year has gone so fast, and obviously Government House, it's a national institution. People love coming to Government House, and it's a great privilege and an honour to live there. So we have really enjoyed settling into life on the islands, and it is the people that make a place, and we have been made very welcome. And I've tried very hard over this first year to be accessible and open, trying to get out as much as possible, supporting the community, doing a lot of events, using social media to try and break down barriers. So I didn't know what Instagram was before I came to Cayman, but everybody says you know. I knew what Twitter was. I've been using Twitter for many years, but Instagram was new. So and that's doing very well. So I hope people enjoy seeing some of the activities, because I think it's important. You can connect with people that you probably wouldn't have much contact with. So I think social media is a very positive tool.
And you've been very intentional in using that as a way to, to have public engagement and to be able to communicate to the people your everyday activities the things that you're tackling each time.
That's right. I think it's a way of showing that I'm supporting the community, but also a way of highlighting and raising particularly sort of important matters. So yeah, I've enjoyed using social media.
So a lot has happened this year. You've been very active. I definitely have seen that, not just in your role as governor, but just immersing yourself in culture and being able to engage and having that Cayman kind wherever you go and experiencing it too.
Yes.
How important was that for you to experience that?
That's been really important, and I've done a number of sort of constituency visits as well with some of our elected politicians, and what's been really nice about that is I've gone into people's homes and meeting many of our people in their homes, and they've invited other people to sort of come and meet me. So that's been really really good. But it has been an incredibly busy year. I mean, we had Prince of Wales and the Duchess of Cornwall. We've had Lord Ahmad, the Minister of the Overseas Territories. Just a few weeks ago, Mark Lancaster, Minister of Defence. And I was really pleased we were able to launch what I think is a really exciting new initiative for a Cayman Islands Defence Regiment. But not just that. I think that this office does a lot of work behind the scenes, working to support Cayman in so many different areas. So whether it's the part funding the new police helicopter, whether it's working with the prisons on the new prison monitoring board, working on mental health with the prisons. We've done a lot on disaster preparedness, working with Cayman to join SEDIMA, the regional body, the visit by RFA Mounts Bay in June, and the beach landing. So there's a lot that goes on sort of behind the scenes to support Cayman, building on the talents and the experience that's here, but using sort of a bit of UK technical expertise where in specific areas that can really help to make a difference.
Tell us your favourite moment this year?
My favourite moment? Well, I think obviously having the heir to the throne arrive in the Cayman Islands when I'd only been here 4 or 5 months. So that was a particularly proud proud moment. But there have been so many highlights, really. And I've learnt to play the steel pan.
Yes.
Which
which is a surprise for a lot of people. I didn't think that you could actually do that, but you did.
Well, I give all the credit to Earl Lapere because he's I know he's a legend on the island, and I have no musical talent whatsoever. I was, I think, the only boy in my class at school who wasn't allowed in the choir.
Oh no!
So Earl has managed to find something. I don't know how he did that, but I have enjoyed learning it, and we're now busy working on another tune for Christmas. So
Ooh.
So I'll give you a scoop Ooh. There.
Thanks for that one. And you've done a lot of tours and a lot of visits throughout the Cayman Islands.
Yes, yes.
And I think you also forgot to mention that you've been a part of a lot of marathons.
Yes.
Recently, the Deputy Governor's 5K.
Thank you. I have done a lot of those. I wouldn't say they were marathons. I think 5K is about my limit, but I do enjoy running. The 5K runs are really, really nice.
Yeah.
And I've done a lot of those to support some fantastic charities on the island that are doing great work. But I also think I think doing exercise is really important. Mm-hmm. Certainly, I know from my own well-being, exercise helps me to sort of keep fit, and it's good for my own sort of mental health. So I build exercise into my daily routine, and that's worked for me for a long time, and I that's something that's important to me. But just supporting the community is what it's about, okay. mainly.
And in your role, Governor Roper, you focus on matters and national issues such as law and order, policing,
yes, yes.
and I believe national security.
Yeah.
Yes. Do you believe that it is a fundamental area for Governor, and how have you been able to achieve most of that throughout this year?
It is a key part of the Governor's responsibility, but working very closely with the Cayman Islands government, because it's a partnership, and I think that's one of my abiding sort of reflections on the year, is just how close that relationship is. I mean, yes, in the Constitution you have different responsibilities, but actually it's a partnership, and we work very well together. So on law and order, I think we have an excellent police commissioner. I've just reappointed him for the next 4 years. I think he's doing a great job, and I think he's modernising and reforming the police, and which I think is a very good thing. I've reinvigorated the National Security Council. Now we're not able to say publicly what it does, but it meets monthly, and it makes sure we keep a strong focus on law and order, bringing all the various people around the table to make sure that we're looking strategically at the threats that we face. I know law and order is of concern to everyone. We see in the newspapers every day there's an incident here, an incident there, but again, if you step back and look sort of regionally, you know, we're doing pretty well, and the challenge is to keep it that way. So I will continue to focus strongly on law and order.
You mentioned earlier in some interviews that you feel that as governor, it is a role that comes with a lot of responsibility and comes with a lot of a great sense of duty and doing that job to the best of your ability. Do you still firmly believe that?
I do. I think, I mean, governor, it is a unique role. And I think being appointed by Her Majesty the Queen just immediately create a unique and special bond with the Cayman Islands and the people of the Cayman Islands. And I see my role as doing everything I can to support the people of the Cayman Islands, enhance our security, enhance our prosperity. And obviously I have to manage that within a framework of UK policies in various areas. But I think that sort of sense of duty and that sense of responsibility is something that I personally feel very strongly, and that, you know, provides me with all the motivation I need to try and do my best for everybody.
All right. Switching gears, Governor Roper. Rapid fire questions. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Go ahead.
70s music
or
80s
music? 80s. I grew up with the 80s, so it's the best decade without any doubt.
Yeah, I think so.
You don't look convinced. Oh, you do?
Yes. Well, I'm a little conflicted with the 90s. But
right.
The 80s,
okay.
Simple Minds or Coldplay?
Or both. I love, actually, if I had to choose one, I would go with Coldplay, and that sort of goes into the 90s a bit, really, but Simple Minds, I also think, are fantastic as well.
Yeah. Okay. playing steel pan or paddle boarding?
Oh, steel pan, any day.
Yeah.
Any day. Yeah, I enjoy both, but the steel pan has been a real revelation. It's a lovely sound.
Mm-hmm. Sunsets or sunrises?
Sunrises, because I like to get up very early.
Yeah, you're right on the beach.
Huh? I do try and run on the beach, yes.
A privilege. Okay. I don't know about this one, but turtle stew or kung stew?
Oh, a turtle stew. Yeah? I've had both, but I actually quite like the turtle stew. And we do sometimes have it at Cabinet every Tuesday. We get different food for lunch. And every now and again, we do have turtle stew. So I've eaten it regularly. And it's lovely. I like turtle
stew. East End turtle stew or the West Bay turtle stew?
That I'm not certain of. But whichever one it was, it was a nice turtle stew.
Okay. Apple crumble and custard or cassava cake?
Ooh, a cassava cake, of course, now that I'm in the Cayman Islands.
Yes, right? Good answer. When I'm not working, I am?
I just relaxing, reading, playing the steel pan, paddleboarding, but just keeping fit. I love to keep fit, so I do try and sort of running as much as I can.
Yeah. And lastly, what's the hope as you continue on in your term?
Well, just to continue to do my best for the islands. I think that the islands have so much to be proud of. There are so many positives. I mean, that really strong Caymanian culture, heritage and tradition, which I've seen. I know people are very proud of that. But combined with a very diverse community of over 130 different nationalities. And that diversity is a real strength. So I will just continue to do my best for the islands. I hope we can continue to get ministers coming through. I would hope we can get another senior royal visitor at some point in the future. So I will continue to strive to do my utmost for everybody on these islands.
All right. With that said, it's been a pleasure, Governor.
Thank you very much.
Happy first.
Thank you very much. Likewise.
You've been listening to the latest edition of Cayman Up Close, written and produced by Radio Cayman's Shanda Gallego. For a podcast of today's show, log on to radiokman.gov.ky. Music by Caymanian artist Paul Chin.